So we have this problem where we are supposed to find the angle between the pair of lines, this and this. Now the most vital thing again becomes how you had derived the equation of the line. How had we done that? Again, I'll re-emphasize. It was either r is equal to r minus a is equal to lambda b, which had given us r is equal to a plus lambda b, or it will be of the form r minus a is equal to lambda b minus a. So that gives you r is equal to a plus lambda b minus a. You should always keep that in mind, that it is this vector just before which you have written the arbitrary constant, which is the vector to which your line is parallel. This thing is the point through which the vector passes. Okay. So if someone asks you what is one fixed point that you are pretty sure about through which the vector is passing, it that point will be, so the point will be 3, 2, minus 4. Okay. That's why its position vector is written as 3i cap plus 2j cap minus 4k cap. So this is the point through which the vector passes. That is one fixed point that was given to you. And this is the vector to which the line is parallel. Okay. This is the vector to which the line is parallel. We understand. We understand that. So, and the same here. Which is the point through which it passes? It is 5 minus 2, 0. Okay, which is the vector to which it is parallel? It is I cap plus 2j cap plus 2k cap. Similarly here, 3i cap plus 2j cap plus 6k cap. Now what do I have to do? To find out the angle between the lines, I just have to find out the angle between the vectors to which they are parallel. That is all. Okay. So I apply my cos theta formula. That tells me it is b1 dot b2. So you understand, this is your b1 and this is your b2. So the moment you go back to how the line came in, you'll immediately understand what are the points and what are the vectors to which they are parallel. Correct? So b1 dot b2 upon mod b1 mod b2. So b1 dot b2 will give me the coefficients to be multiplied. 3, 4 and 12. So 3 into 1, or I can write 1 into 3 plus 2 into 2 plus 2 into 6 divided by, what is mod of this? This is root over 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square into 3 square plus 2 square plus 6 square. And that will give me 3 and 4, 7 and 12, 19. This is 3 root over 9 and this is 49. So that gives me 19 upon 3 into 7. So that gives me 19 upon 21. So cos theta is that. So theta is equal to cos inverse. You can leave it there.
Or if you are given a trigonometric table, then you can find out the angle from there. Obviously, you will not be given a calculator. Okay. Calculator, you will not be given. Anyone having that phone with a scientific calculator? No? Yeah. So, so
I punch in 19 divided by 21, it is equal to this. And what is cos inverse of that? 19 divided by 21 is equal to what? It's in radians. Into 180 divided by 3.14.
So that's about 25 degree, okay?
So cos inverse 19 divided by 25.2
degrees, okay? So this is actually 25.2 degrees, okay? Now the matter does not end here. Since you are given the equation in a vector form, it is easy to recognize the vectors to which your line is parallel. The moment it is given in a Cartesian form, things change. Okay? But you should understand what had happened in the Cartesian form. How do you represent the Cartesian form? For example, let me pick up a question. So find out the angle between the pair of the lines. Okay? So I am doing this example 10 here, okay? So find the angle between the lines. Tell me the lines. X plus
3 upon 3 equals to y minus 1 upon 5.
5
equals to z plus 3 upon 4
and
x plus 1 upon 1
equals
to y minus 4 upon 1
equals
to z minus 5 upon 2.
You understand? We had seen that my A1, B1 and C1 come here. Okay? That we had deduced from here, isn't it? I had equated r minus a to lambda b. So I had got x minus a I cap plus y minus, x minus x1 I cap plus y minus y1 j cap plus z minus z1 k cap is equal to lambda a I cap plus b j cap plus c k cap, isn't it? This is what we had got. And from there what had happened? X minus x1 upon a had become y minus y1 upon b, had become z minus z1 upon c. So whatever falls down, whatever is in my denominator, when this has one as the coefficient. Be very, very particular about it. Okay, I'll just show you an example where things become a bit difficult. So, and this is A2, B2, C2. So, if I am asked which are the vectors to which my line are parallel, so B1 will be 3i cap plus 5j cap plus 4k cap. And B2 is 1 I cap, which I write as I cap, plus J cap, plus 2 K cap. Understand? So now you can proceed, right? So immediately what I do, cos theta is equal to B1 dot B2 divided by mod B1 into mod B2. What is B1 dot B2? Again the same thing, 3 into 1, so 3 plus 5 plus 8. Divide by mod of this, so 9 plus 25, 34 plus 16. 9 plus 25 is 34 plus 16 is root 50. And this is 1 plus 1, root 2 6. plus, so root 6. And this is 16, and this is root over 300. So this is actually
actually what? 5 root 2 and this is? So, 300, they are actually 300, right? Root 300 is 10 root 3.
So, 16 upon 10 root 3. 16 upon 10 root 3 cos inverse of that.
So, theta is equal to cos inverse 16 upon 10 root 3.
10 root 3 is somewhere about 17.32, right?
So I find cos inverse, I'm using a calculator. So 16 divided by 10 into root 3, that gives me 22.5 degree.
So that is 22.5 degrees.
Okay.
Correct.
So you have to identify from the Cartesian or the vector form of equation what we are talking about. This is what the equation is.
So 3, 5, 4, 1, 1, 2. So 3 plus 5 is 8, plus 8 is 16.
He showed me something that's a bit different. Root 3 then multiplied by root 3, so this became 30 and this became 16 root 3, so it became 8 root 3 by 15.